Hello children, now we are going to read the lesson in geography chapter 1. Okay, take your geography book, open your book to the page number 1. See, what is the lesson name? The Earth in the Solar System. What is the lesson? The Earth in the Solar System. How wonderful it is to watch the sky after sunset. 1. Would first notice one or two bright dots shining in the sky. Soon, you would see the number increasing. You cannot count them anymore. What is this? We can't count them. Yeah, absolutely, it's a stars. The whole sky is filled with tiny shining objects. Some are bright, others dim. It seems as if the sky is studded with diamonds. They all appear to be twinkling, but if you look at them carefully, you will notice that some of them do not twinkle as others do. They simply glow without any flicker, just as the moon shines. Along with these bright objects, you may also see the moon on most of the days. It may, however, appear at different times, in different shapes and at different positions. You can see the full moon only once in about a month's time. It is full moon night or Purnami. I mean, in English we have to say Purnima. What is a Purnami in English? Purnima. A fortnight later, you cannot see it at all. It is a new moon night or Amavasya. What is that? Amavasya. On this day, you can watch the night sky best, provided it is a clear night. Do you wonder why can't we see the moon and all those bright tiny objects during daytime? Why? We can't see because of the sunlight, it's hiding all those things. But everything is to be there only. It is because the very bright light of the sun does not allow us to see all these bright objects of the night sky. The sun, the moon and all those objects shining in the night sky are called celestial bodies. What is the meaning of celestial? Celestial means vana ellai. Okay. Some celestial bodies are very big and hot. They are made up of gases. They have their own heat and light, which they emit in large amounts. Thus, these celestial bodies are called stars. So, sun also is a star. The sun is a star. Countless twinkling stars in the night sky are similar to the sun. But we do not feel their heat or light, and they look so tiny because they are very, very far from us. For example, if you count the stars, we can't count that how many stars are in the sky because it makes us to be some confusion. That's why. Okay. You must have noticed that all objects look smaller when seen from a distance. How small an aeroplane looks when it is flying at a great height. While watching the night sky, you may notice various patterns formed by the different groups of stars. These are called constellations. What is this? Constellations. Ursa Major or Big Bear is one such constellation. Ursa Minor, Ursa Major also is a constellations only. One of the most easily recognizable constellation is Saptarishi. It means seven Rishi sages, Elu Munivargal. It is a group of seven stars that forms a part of Ursa Major constellations. So how many stars in the Ursa Major constellation? Seven stars. Ask someone elder in your family or neighborhood to show you more stars, planets and constellations in the sky. In ancient times, people used to determine directions during the night with the help of stars. The north star indicates the north direction. It is also called the pole star. What do you mean by pole star? Which star references the north side and north direction? It's called a pole star. It always remains in the same position in the sky. We can locate the position of the pole star with the help of the Saptarishi. Look at figure 1.1, this one. Okay, you will notice that if an imaginary line drawn joining the pointer stars and extended further, it will point to be the pole star. See here, we have so many stars here. This is North Star. She is standing near the west side. So how many stars are here? Totally 7. So while seeing, no, this is called a pole star. Okay. For example, when you see the sky around near to you, if you see 7 stars first of all. Okay. And then wherever you focus on north side, near the 7 stars, you have to focus on north side. That time you will see the pole star. See the next one. Some celestial bodies do not have their own heat and light. They are lit by the light of the stars. Such bodies are called planets. Yeah, how many planets we have? 7 planets. The word planet comes from Greek word planetai, which means wondrous. Wondrous means suthi thirinjikite irukkaranga. The earth on which we live is a planet. It gets all its heat and light from the sun, which is our nearest star. If we look at the earth from a great distance, say the moon, it will appear to be shining just as the moon. The moon that we see in the sky is a satellite. Yeah, what is the satellite of the earth? The moon. It is the companion of our earth and moves round it like our earth. There are 8 other planets that get heat and light from the sun. Some of them have their moons too. Moons too means like a satellites. See here the interesting fact. Jupiter, Saturn and Uranus have rings around them. Yeah, the belts of small debris. These rings may be seen from the earth with the help of powerful telescopes. Let's see the solar system. Already while teaching the session, I have explained to you what are the 8 planets, satellites, sun. So what are the, except those things, what are the celestial bodies are in the sky, those things I have referred to you. See now, the sun, 8 planets, satellites and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteoroids. See here, this is the planet. Here we have the sun. First planet is Mercury. Second one Venus, third one Earth, fourth one Mars. This is the asteroid belt. What is the black hole we have a belt, no? That is called a asteroid belt. Okay, these rings and all, these are orbit. These rings and all, what is that? Orbit. The first biggest planet in the Earth, in the solar system, Jupiter. Then Saturn, then Uranus. At last, Neptune. Okay. So, what are the planets near to the sun? We have to say that inner planets. What are the planets after the asteroid belt? Those things are what we have to call outer planets. See here, they have given inner planets and outer planets. How many days are they will spin on the axis? Those things and all. Okay. See this. Turn the next page. See here. Do you know? Sol in Roman mythology is the sun god. Solar means related to the sun. The family of the sun is therefore called the solar system. Write down as many words using the word solar on your own as you can. Word origin. Word origin means how the word is getting the birth. Like we are getting birth and all like that. Many words used in a language may have been taken from some other language. Geography, for example, is an English word. It has its origin in Greek, which relates to the description of the earth. It is made of 2 Greek words, G meaning earth, graphia meaning writing. So find out more about the earth. Geology is a study of the earth. Geometry is a measurement of the earth. Then geoid, it's resembling the shape or form the earth. Do you know? Humans have always been fascinated gazing at the night sky. Those who study the celestial bodies and their movements are called astronomers. Aryabhatta was a famous astronomer of ancient India. He said that the moon and the planets shining due to reflected the sunlight. Today, astronomers all over the world are busy exploring the universe. See here, form the solar system. We often call it a solar family with the sun as its head. Who is the king of our solar family? The sun. Description about the sun. The sun is in the center of the solar system. It's a huge and made up of extremely hot gases, helium and hydrogen gases only in the sun. It provides the pulling force that binds of the solar system. The sun is the ultimate source of heat and light for the solar system. But the tremendous heat is not felt so much by us because despite being our nearest star, it is far away from us. The sun is about 150 million kilometers away from the Earth. Planets. There are 8 planets in our solar system. In order of their distance from the sun, they are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. We should not change this order. We have to write those planets' name in the orders only. Then how we have to memorize this? Already I said no. My very efficient mother just served as a nuts. All these 8 planets of the solar system move around the sun in fixed paths. These paths are elongated, so they are called orbits. Mercury is the nearest to the sun. It takes only about 88 days to complete one round along its orbit. Venus is considering as its twin because its size and shape are very much similar to of that Earth. Till recently, August 2006. Pluto was also considered a planet. However, in a meeting of the International Astronomical Union, a decision was taken. The Pluto like other celestial objects. So we should not consider this one as a planet. So we have to call the Pluto as a dwarf planet. What is that? Dwarf planet. Dwarf planet means planet aga nama eduthukka koodadhu. Oru vagaiyana poliyana. What is that? Poliyana oru. We will see in the about Earth and the Moon, those things in our next class. Okay, students, read those things up to these. We will continue on our next class. Thank you.